Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to be doing the first video of 2020, which is pretty crazy. I hope that you guys all had a really good holiday and are excited for the new year. But in terms of today's video, we are going to be looking at the clout house. Team 10. The White House? My sincerest apologies. The hype house. In the past few weeks, I've actually gotten a few requests to look at the hype house in my DMs, and I'm gonna be honest, the first couple times I saw the words the hype house in my DMs, I looked at it not knowing what the fuck it was, and there was just something in my gut that was saying, wow, I don't think I want to touch this one with a 10-foot pole. But after looking into it a little bit more, I thought it would definitely be an interesting topic for a video, so that's what we're going to be talking about today. Of course, before we start today's video, we have to do this week's sweaty shoutout, and this week it goes to Grace Alyssa underscore who sent this tweet. What's the mood tonight, you ask? This, I say. Barbie girl playing in the distance while you were in a wet cave full of rats. If you want to get a sweaty shout out for yourself, all you have to do is subscribe to me on YouTube and then follow me on Instagram and DM your favorite meme of the week on Instagram and you might get chosen. So for those of you who don't know what the Hype House is, it's essentially a social media group network kind of thing, similar to the Team 10 format, and I think they're called the Clout Gang. Or they're called like the Clout something. It's very similar to that, except instead of YouTubers, they're TikTokers. Now, from what I've been able to find online, it looks like there's either 14 or 19 members in the group. According to their Instagram, it seems like it's 14, and they also seem to all own the exact same pair of jeans. But according to other people online, it seems like people have been added since those photos came out. So it may be 19, maybe it's 14. I'm just gonna put both those numbers out and hope that one of them is right. In terms of the members though, it seems like there's only three qualifications that you need to join the Hype House, which are to be between 15 and 22 years old, have a sizable TikTok following, and be white. One of the first dramas that ensued with the Hype House was that the roster was overwhelmingly white, which is a completely valid criticism in my opinion. I mean, there are numerous TikTok creators that aren't white that would have fit into the Hype House probably quite well. Don't know why they wouldn't have just put them in. Doesn't really make any sense to me. It seems like the point of the Hype House is that you have all of these young TikTok stars who all have millions of followers living with each other so that they can constantly collaborate with each other, share each other's audiences, and at the base level, it does sound like a good idea. I feel like everyone who would be a part of the Hype House would probably get a pretty good follower boost from being there, but it does make me wonder, what kind of content do you have to make on TikTok to be able to get into this ever-exclusive Hype House? She saw me one time. What? Okay, but that's only two of them. There's no way that everyone in this house is putting out content like that. The title on this one is You in Danger, and if you're wondering of what, it doesn't seem like they know. The only context, at least in my mind, that would help this video make sense is that these three people were going to do a Riptide performance for their high school talent show, and then the day before the talent show, their high school decides to ban ukuleles, and this is what they come up with instead? Yeah, I don't get this. Now, while the content that the individual members of the Hype House are putting on their own profiles is not really within my interests, I am quite interested in what the actual Hype House account has on their profile, because you would assume that because all of these creators are now living together, they're paying rent to live with each other and are essentially backing their TikTok career with money in the sense that they're renting out a place in LA, that the content on the Hype House account is going to be just... How do I say this? I don't want to say have effort put into it because I'm sure that there is effort behind the dance videos, but I guess I mean that I'm expecting that the Hype House content is going to be a little bit more... Is the word dynamic? I think it's dynamic. My heart's so cold, I think I'm done with ice. Birds, if I leave her, she gon' die. Well, bitch, you done with life. Okay, better not pull up with no knife, cause I bring guns to fight. Boom. Say you got that sack, I got that sack, but ain't no ones of mine. In the clip, you see E-E-2. What I'll do, you won't come you. ARs and them 2-2-3. Fucking around with me, you see I'm hot on 500 degrees. Heard he caught a body, but that does not mean shit to me. Nope, it's literally just the dance stuff. All right. Don't get me wrong here. I have nothing against the TikTok dance community. I think that the dances look like a lot of fun and they're really cute. But is this all they're gonna do? Like, they rented out a house so that 14 to 19 people could just do 10-second dances with each other? More than anything, I'm just genuinely curious on what the expected shelf life on this thing is supposed to be. Now, in terms of the actual dynamic between the members of the Hype House, it seems like they're taking yet another page out of Team 10's book, and they have one of those they could be, but they also could not be dating kind of relationships, similar to the Jake Paul and Alyssa Violet and Jake Paul and Erica Costell relationships, except for the Hype House, it seems to be between someone who is going by Lil Huddy and then a girl named Charlie. Now, if that name sounds slightly familiar, it might be because you recognize him from the Lights Out tour, which he was also on. His actual name is Chase Hudson, and that's what we'll be calling him in today's video because me calling somebody Lil Huddy for 15 minutes is not something that's gonna be happening today. That might be where you recognize him from. He was a part of that whole Lights Out tour fiasco. If you don't know what the Lights Out tour is, essentially a bunch of TikTok e-boys went on a tour in the summer for some reason. I have a video on it that continues to haunt me. If you wanna check that out, I will link it in the description. But in terms of the Charlie girl, she also had a bit of drama around her, but it's the weirdest situation I've personally ever seen. Now, the reason that I know about the Charlie girl a little bit more than I know other Hype House members is because a couple weeks back, I actually got quite a few requests to do a video on her only because of some meet and greet thing that happened. And from my knowledge, apparently what happened was she spiked on TikTok, got a ton of followers, and then did a meet and greet really close to like gaining a lot of followers. So a lot of people felt like it was a bit quick to do a meet and greet. And the prices apparently were super expensive, and people were super pissed about it. That's personally why I didn't do a video on it. I feel like there's literally nothing wrong with charging that much if you're gonna give it all to charity. I think there's definitely something to be said about an ego if you get famous and then a week later you're charging like $800 for a meet and greet where you're directly profiting. But I feel like if you get that spike in popularity and you go, hey, like, I could possibly get someone to donate $800 to a charity, I feel like that's actually kind of cool. When I did find out though that she was giving it all to charity, I was kind of surprised that there were so many people acting, or I guess responding as aggressively as they were, because it didn't take me very long to find out that it was all going to charity. So I can't imagine that the average person who's offering their hot take on the subject wouldn't be able to find that as well. I will say what I found interesting about that situation is when I was doing kind of like, I don't want to say research because it really wasn't research. I was literally just Googling the situation to get an idea on if it was something I could make a video on or not. And when I looked into it took me like 2 seconds to realize it was going to charity. So it was kind of confusing to me why so many people were being so aggressive with the responses to this young girl when it takes 2 seconds to realize that she's actually giving it all to charity. Like, I don't know, like people were just giving such descriptive hot takes for something that they could have taken 2 seconds to realize was not necessary at all. But I do think for the most part, the reason that the response was so aggressive was because it seems like a lot of people, for literally no reason, just don't like this girl because her comment section is the most toxic place I've ever witnessed for someone who hasn't actually done anything bad, if that makes sense. By that, I don't mean that anyone would do something that would deserve a really toxic comment section. I just mean it was quite jarring almost that this girl who's quite young, quite newly viral, and hasn't really done anything controversial yet, has just hundreds and hundreds of comments from people who are just so salty. I'm sorry, I went on a bit of a tangent there, but what I was just trying to say is that there's this weird amount of controversy and dislike for her that doesn't really line up with what she's done so far on social media in terms of like being controversial. But it seems like her and Chase are putting out a ton of videos where they kind of make it seem like maybe they could be dating, but they also leave just enough room that it leaves the viewers wondering maybe they aren't.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, hi, J, K, just kidding, L, M, N, O, laugh my nose off.
But of course, they're not confirming it and are rather just letting their fans continue to make theories on it. Now, out of all the Hype House profiles that have been made by the members of the Hype House in the past couple weeks since it's been announced, it seems like the TikTok profile is the most followed, then their Instagram, and then their YouTube channel is an interesting situation considering the channel I'm about to show you, I'm Still not 100% sure if it's actually the legit Hype House channel because members of the Hype House have been linking the wrong Hype House YouTube channel in their video descriptions for weeks. So the one that I'm showing you today is basically my best guess on the most legit looking Hype House YouTube channel there is right now on YouTube, and the video uploads on here are weird as hell. At the point of filming this right now, it seems like the channel exclusively consists of 10 to 20 second videos that are insanely random and have the most bare minimum titles I've ever witnessed. Just doing TikTok with the boys. What's better than this? Guys being dudes? No, no. Just doing TikToks with the boys. Ha ha. Ha ha ha.
It's Little Huddy in a little hoodie.
Come on, he's such a dad, I swear. You're literally the dad of the group, I swear.
Behind the scene.
Good. Okay. Yep. Uh-huh.
Nice.
Whoa.
Keep it clean.
Let's go, ladies.
There you go.
Up, up, up. Okay. Nice.
I don't know about you guys, but personally, when I found out that the Hype House did have a YouTube channel, I was kind of expecting like long form content, like maybe at the bare minimum you had like a Q&A with all the members, or maybe you do like those tag things that there's at least something. But as of right now, we aren't even really sure. Like, we're sure there is a channel because members have linked the wrong Hype House YouTube channel. We're just not sure which one it is. And I really hope this isn't their actual channel, considering that right now it's a damn mess. I don't know, it just seems weird that they would make a YouTube channel, but all they're doing is just reposting TikToks that already exist on their TikTok, meaning if you follow them on TikTok, there is literally no reason why you would need to subscribe to their YouTube channel. And instead of taking advantage of the fact that YouTube has longer form content, they're just posting shorter content that YouTube doesn't even really favor as much these days. I just don't get it. One thing I did notice when I was looking into the Hype House to make this video was that there's a real lack of content showing everyone in the house together and like things going on in the house. It seems like it's more so just like super short TikToks trying to show everybody at once, and that's about it. But it seems like Chase has uploaded a video where we can get a bit of a clear idea on the dynamic of the house and everyone in it and what kind of content we should expect from them in the future.
I moved into a new house. Yeah! You guys are gonna like it. Get ready! I'm gonna introduce you to some of the people that so far are living in this house. Let's do it!
Ooh. So I'm currently sleeping on the floor and Nick's jealous that I have more blankets than him, and he has...
It's like 30 degrees in here!
You have a mattress!
But it feels like a jail mattress!
In honor of getting a new house, I decided to break it in a little bit. And what better way to break it in but with a hypnotist?
We got everybody here?
Yeah.
Is that what you'd imagine? I reach in and take your name from wherever it's in your mind, and I just put it back. So now you know it's
Patty.
There we go. And I reach in, and I've stolen it, and it's gone again. Your name was...
This is some of the most bare minimum shit I've ever seen. I do want to say that while I do think that from what I've seen from the Hype House right now screams bare minimum, I don't want that to take away from the fact that I don't necessarily think that the idea is bad per se. Apparently the idea for the house actually came from an ex-Team 10 member named Thomas Petro. I'm not really sure how to pronounce his last name, but he left Team 10 and is now helping to create the Hype House. And I'm sure that a lot of people are getting sick of seeing all these social media supergroups, but the reason that they're so popular is because when they're done right, they can be quite a mutually beneficial situation for everyone who's a part of them. The issue, though, is that a lot of them aren't done right. Like, when you actually look at what the bare bones of a social media supergroup, which we're just gonna call them that for now because I don't know what else to call them, it's based on things that have actually proved to be successful in the past. Like, that kind of joining of a bunch of people, it's basically like a mega collaboration where everyone's able to collaborate with each other constantly. And we've seen in the past that collaborations are an amazing way to grow your audience, because not only are you getting the exposure to somebody else's audience, you're also getting that creator's stamp of approval subconsciously told to the audience because they know that a creator wouldn't collaborate with somebody else if they didn't like their content themselves. So by having all these TikTok stars who have massive followings all join together and live together and create the hype house together, they're essentially joining all of their audiences together and giving everyone exposure. And then even from the sponsorship perspective, they're obviously going to get a lot more money per sponsorship if they're shopping themselves as this mini network that has reach in the hundreds of millions versus just as individuals with like 5 million reach, which isn't a takeaway from like the number 5 million. That's obviously a lot of people, but compared to 100 million, you're gonna get a lot more money. And the reason that I'm saying all this is because I don't want people to read the title of this video and then connect it to presuming that I don't like the idea of social media supergroups, because I do think in its bare state that it actually could be a really beneficial way for creators to grow and help each other in the future. Like, the idea of having a mini network where you're one YouTuber as a part of like a 20 YouTuber team, where you're all in a similar genre, you all help each other and pay attention to each other and shop yourselves to different sponsors, makes a lot more sense than joining these massive networks where you're one in 10,000 YouTubers, and if you don't have enough subscribers, they just don't pay attention to you and just take a percentage of your AdSense every month. But while I do think this is a good idea at its core, I don't think there is a single existing example right now that really proves to be the best version of what it could be. And the main reason that I'm so skeptical about the hype house is because they're showing early signs of crashing and burning like the other social media groups that came before it, because they're focusing more on how famous the members are versus creating original content with those members. I'm not sure if that completely made sense, but what I'm trying to say is that there seems to be little effort put into the hype house TikToks beyond just putting really famous members of the hype house into TikToks together and collabing, which works now and is working pretty well for them, but I feel like recycling the same collaborations between 14 to 19 people are gonna start to get really old, especially if you're not even differentiating the content that you're putting on different platforms in the first place. Honestly, I don't even really know what to make of this video. I'm not even sure if this is really like an explanation of the house or more so, I guess, like a discussion, because I still kind of feel quite confused on how to feel about it. I mean, like, I hope it works out for everyone, but also it's gonna be interesting to see how everything pans out, but hopefully, if you didn't know what the hype house was before watching this video, you have a bit more of an idea of what it is, and if you already knew about it, hopefully you just enjoyed listening and hearing a bit more about it maybe. If you did enjoy the video, feel free to give it a like and subscribe to the channel, and if you want to be updated every single time that I upload, you can turn my post notifications on, and you can follow me outside of YouTube on Twitter and Instagram, which are both Casey Aonso. Anyways, once again, I hope that you guys enjoyed the video, and I will see you guys in the next one.